Welcome class 7 to my channel Social Minds. Through this video we are going to start a new chapter, Understanding Media. What we are going to study in this chapter, these are the topics media and mass media, then media and technology, what kind of role will be played by technology in the field of media, then role of money in media. What does TV do and what can we do with TV, setting agendas and local media. So these are the topics which we are going to study in this chapter. First of all, media. Media is the plural form of the word medium. Medium means any agency which helps in doing something. So media is the term which applies to the communication. It has become synonymous with those means of dissemination such as newspaper, magazines, films, radio, television, web word, books, CDs, DVDs, etc. So these are the ways, these are the sources through which we can communicate with the society. So everything ranging from a phone call to news on television can be called as media. Media refers to all means of communication. Now, as you can see in this picture, these are the sources, these are the ways by which the communication can be done. With the help of the newspaper, with the help of the radio, TV, satellites, these are the examples of the sources of the communication. These are the actually the medium or the agencies by which the communication can be done with society. Now, the term mass media. Usually, the media is called the mass media when the information will be shared to millions of people or the masses across the country and the world with the help of radio, newspaper or TV. So this is called the mass media because such information reaches millions of people inside and outside the country at the same time. ठीक है? TV से, रेडियो से, न्यूज़पेपर से एक ही इंफॉर्मेशन लाखों लोगों तक एक कंट्री में भी और कंट्री से बाहर भी लोगों के पास एक ही सोर्स से पहुंच रही है, तो दैट इज कॉल्ड मास मीडिया. नाउ इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ मीडिया. मीडिया हेल्प टू गेट कनेक्टेड विद लॉट्स ऑफ पीपल बिकॉज इट हेल्प्स टू डिसेमिनेट द इंफॉर्मेशन. Then media help to share our views with others and learn about other views. When we share our opinion with others, in the same way we are getting their opinions also. So we get a chance to learn something new. In this way it help to gather knowledge also. And today modern media help to run education, banking, business and many other works also. Media serves the purpose of enriching education. It spreads our culture and civilization to the world level. Yes, technology and media. If I say that technology and media are interwoven and neither can be separated from contemporary society, from today's society, they cannot be separated. And if I say that they are like twin brothers who are exactly alike, who cannot live without each other. So technology, the relation between the technology and media is like that. We know that mass media uses various technologies. These technologies always keep changing. Using such technology, mass media can reach more and more people. Now, see, previously there was no printing press. So when printing press was invented in Germany, the circulation, the printing circulation increased a lot. It reached to more people. In the same way, second example we can take of cable television. Previously there was no cable television, but now we have cable connections in almost all houses. It has advanced to the level of DTH, direct to home system of this technology. Now we can enjoy on any channel or any program as we wish. This has definitely increased the number of viewers of television. Same internet, that is also recent phenomena, and with the help of the internet we are in a position to reach to larger number of people. So this is that media, the sphere of the media is increasing day by day due to the latest technology. Now, modern media is a recent phenomena. We know that these are the ways internet, television, radio, newspaper, magazines, books, etc. So these are the sources of media which we can divide into two categories, print media and electronic media. Now, the electronic media includes broadcasting and telecasting through radio and television. Various types of, you can say, the social medias also, that also comes in the electronic media, and print media. Print media applies to the publishing industry, which in a narrow sense means books, newspaper, magazines and journals. So there are the two types of media, print media and electronic media. Importance of technology. We know that media uses so many technology. Media changes its technology and make it modern with time. Now these are the pictures which are in front of you. By viewing these pictures you can see that how technology changes with time. Earlier we have TV which was black and white TV with only two buttons by which we can change the channel or we can improve the quality of sound or the quality of picture. But now that TV turns into a smart TV. Okay? So this is the change in technology. In the same way, the phones, you can see that earlier we have the landlines only, but now we have iPhones also. So this is also an example of changing technology. And by using latest technology, now media reaches more and more people. And even technology, the new technology improves sound and images that we see. It enabled us to see entertainment channel from other part of the world. Like we are sitting in India, but we are in a position to see the cartoons of Japan and USA. So this is just because of the advent of technology. Media and money. The different technologies that mass media use are expensive. And here I have taken the example of TV studio. Now, in TV studio, or to establish the TV studio, man needs lights, cameras, sound recorders, transmission satellites, okay? And lights like this, cameras, which covers all the angles. So this is just not only one camera in the TV studio, then the satellite technology, and all these things require a lot of money. So money is also very important for media, because the fast growing technological aspect in media has given birth to the prominence of money in it. It is getting expensive or costlier day by day. So now we learned that technology that media uses is very expensive. Besides that, there are many people involved in this work need to be paid. Cameraman है, lightman है, sound recordist है. So many people are involving in that TV studio work who are responsible for showing the news on the news channel. So all those people needs to pay. So mass media is constantly thinking of ways to earn money. कि वो सब एक्सपेंसेस को पूरा करने के लिए मीडिया को मनी कहाँ से अर्न करनी है. सो दैट इज़ द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ एडवर्टीजमेंट. नाउ एडवर्टीजमेंट इज द वे बाय विच द मीडिया हाउस कैन अर्न द मनी बिकॉज डिफरेंट न्यूज़ एजेंसीज और मीडिया मैनेजर्स इनवाइट कमर्शियल एडवर्टीजमेंट विच ब्रिंग देम मनी as commercial advertisement through TV or films or through any other source of media put greater impact on the public. Like see, when we are watching the news or when we are watching a particular movie, if advertisement of any product comes in between, it attracts our attention like this. If we are watching the movie, then the advertisement of suppose 5-star comes, so it attracts our attention. ठीक है. और at some on any day even we want to buy this kind of chocolate. In the same way, if we are reading the newspaper and in that newspaper if this ad of the car is published, so we will see this ad and maybe we will make up our mind to buy this car. So these are the kind of the commercial advertisement which are in the which are being telecasted in the news channel or published in the newspaper. And the cost to advertise on a news channel depends on the popularity of the channel and it depends upon the seconds also ki ek ad kitne seconds ke liye hai. So the cost of that advertisement can varies from rupees 5000 to unlimited extent. ठीक है. That is per 10 second. तो advertisement कितनी duration का है उसके ऊपर उसकी cost depend करती है and that money will be earned by the media house. So this is the way that media can earn the money. Role of media in democracy. Media plays a very significant role in providing information about everything that is happening in a democratic country and keeps the people alert. It serves as a link between the government and the citizens. What the government plans, what step it is going to take in order to implement various plans, whether these plans will serve the interest of the common masses or not, all these vital informations are conveyed to the public through media. Thus, media is the most important means for the formation of public news because media is presenting everything about the government working system. So, by reporting current events and interpreting them to the readers, it helps them to take an intelligent part in the affairs of the country. So, when we see the news on the news channel or when we read the news in the newspaper, by that we come to the conclusion whether the government is doing good for the country or not, and we can take actions. Because it teaches the public to make such demands upon the government as are of common interest. It inspires us to pressurize the government or to postpone some action which is likely to go against the public interest, jo hamare interest ke khilaf jaate hain. Sometimes the public, on the basis of the reports or the news published by the media, take action against the government or a particular ministry to pressurize them to reconsider their program, etc. For that, the public can write letters to the concerned ministry. They can also organize a public protest in this regard. Signature campaigning is yet another way of showing their discontent or anger or can put pressure on the government. So this media is very important. It has to play a very important role in democracy. And this is just not only highlight the working of the government. Beside that, it also discusses events taking place in the country and the world. And in this, when media has to present the news, then the media needs to be independent, clear, so that it can criticize the unpopular program and policies of the government. And when media is independent, only then media can be the fourth pillar of the democracy, because it gives strength to a democratic country, it gives strength to democratic institutions and procedures. Now, public protest. In public protest, people gather together and openly state their oppositions to some issues. If this is the way by which they can show their discontentment, and they can do this by organizing a rally, by starting a signature campaign and blocking roads. These are some of the ways in which this public protest can be done. Balanced report and independent media. People trust in media. Therefore, it is the duty of the media to provide balanced information, which highlights all the necessary aspects of any situation with positive intention, without any pressure or compulsion. So, the report should present the views of all the angles of the story, and then leaves it to the reader to make up their mind. Now, this balanced report is possible only when the media is independent and not the biased one. So, media, and sometimes we observe that media presents distorted views which mislead the public, and even the newspapers also use provocative language and give hot headlines to attract the attention of the public. But media should not function in such an irresponsible manner. Whatever it reports, it should be balanced. It should discuss all points of view of any particular story, and it should not try to influence the mind of the public. Instead, it should let them free to make up their minds. So, that is called the balanced report. Now, for presenting the balanced report, media needs to be independent. Or we can say that media, if we want balanced information, we should give the independence to the media. So, no control or influence should guide or mold any coverage of news, as democracy is a government where public is the most vital aspect, because people are the ultimate source of power in democratic country. So, media should play an honest role. It should not make any provocation. Instead, it should take a balanced view, and that independence can be judged by whether a media house can bring out information without interference from the government or the private sector to some extent or not. But when we observed in reality, we observed that media is not absolutely independent. It is far from independence, and this is mainly because of two reasons. In the first place, it is influenced by the government of the time, and secondly, it works under the influence of the views of the particular agencies or the journalists which run it. So, the first one is that censorship. Censorship refers to the power that government has to disallow media from publishing or showing certain stories. Through it, the government can cut, modify, or ban any of the news to be published by the मीडिया। ठीक है, तो सेंसरशिप में गवर्नमेंट के पास पावर है कि गवर्नमेंट किसी भी न्यूज़ को पब्लिश होने से पहले या टेलीकास्ट होने से पहले उसके कुछ पार्ट को कट कर सकती है, मॉडिफाई कर सकती है या पूरी तरह से उसे डिलीट कर सकती है। दैट इज़ कॉल्ड सेंसरशिप। एंड द वर्स्ट केस ऑफ दिस सिचुएशन इन इंडिया हैड बीन फेस्ड ड्यूरिंग 75 to 77 when the then government led by Prime Minister Indira Gandhi declared a state of emergency under Article 352 of the Constitution of India. And as a result, we saw historical political upheaval in the country, because after this, after the imposition of this emergency, the then government, ruling government suffered a setback. Next is biased media. Now, biased media, that it refers to the bias of journalist or the news procedures within the mass media in the selection of events and stories that are reported. So, if we look into the matter, it is under the control of that journalist only. ठीक है, सो वट एवर द स्टोरीज आर गोइंग टू बी शोन ऑन दैट न्यूज़ चैनल और टू बी पब्लिश इन द न्यूज़ पेपर दैट आर बींग इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाई दिस जर्नलिस्ट ओपिनियन। इन द सेम वे, इफ द मीडिया इज अंडर द कंट्रोल ऑफ अ बिजनेस हाउस, देन दैट बिजनेस हाउस कैन कंट्रोल द न्यूज ऑफ दैट आर गोइंग टू बी टेलीकास्ट ऑन द न्यूज टीवी चैनल और दी इन द न्यूज पेपर। नेक्स्ट वन इज, वट डज टीवी डू टू अस एंड वट कैन वी डू विद टीवी। वी आर लिविंग इन द एज ऑफ केबल टेलीविजन। इट इज द टेलीविजन विच वाइडन्स आर आउटलुक एंड मेक्स अस थिंक ऑफ आर सेल्स एज मेंबर ऑफ द लार्जर global world, because with the help of this TV technology, now the world is shrinking, or TV is also called as window on the world. So this television actually influences our life. It has a great impact on our life. It shapes our views. We make our impressions about the world around us by what we see on television. Several programs ranging from family to politics that are televised on the television screen, they all are attractive enough to catch our attention. Thus, a situation is created which makes us unable to think beyond the world of television. But we should not give the right to televisions to shape our ideas or beliefs. They must be formed by ourselves in due course of time. So we need to be active viewers. Clear? Local media. In order to highlight the problems of ordinary people and their daily lives, local groups start their own media, which is called local media. People belonging to these local groups use community radio, which enlightens farmers about many things such as prices of different crops. Farmers are also advised to use seeds and fertilizers. The local people sometimes make documentary films with fairly cheap and easily available video cameras, which our poor communities face in their day-to-day life. So local media becomes popular among the local people because it is generally written or that are shown in their own local language. So one such example we have of Khabar Lehriya, which is a fortnightly that is run by 8 Dalit women in Chitrakoot district in Uttar Pradesh. It's written in the local language Bundeli. This is 8-page newspaper, and it reports on Dalit issues and cases of violence against women and political corruption. The newspaper reaches farmers, shopkeepers, panchayat members, school teachers, and women who have recently learned to read and write. Social advertising. Social advertisement refer to advertisements made by the government or private agencies that have a larger message for society. This is the picture which highlights or which gives the message to the public while crossing the manned or unmanned level crossing. So any kind of the advertisement which give message to the public, like say no to drugs, or the advertisement related to the save environment, save water, like this. So any advertisement which give message to public is comes under the category of social advertising. Now this is all for the chapter Understanding Media, and we can conclude this chapter by saying that an honest media should decide its points to focus on. The news item should always be for the welfare of the masses, welfare of the people. It should not exploit the sentiments of the people, nor should it highlight anything which may adversely affect the society. Clear? Ki media ko wo news highlight karne chahiye jisme logo ki bhalai ho. Clear? So especially in a country like India, where a large majority of people is facing several problems associated with their living, so the news related to the fashion week has no significance when the media just cover up that fashion week, or like this when the people is facing so many other problems. So media should decide its points to focus on, kahan focus karna hai, and that is called the setting agendas by the media. So this is all for this chapter. With this we come to the end of the chapter, and thank you for listening to me, and stay tuned for the next video. Have a great day.